Top 10 Amazing Coach-Built Cars in the World 2021. Hello, lovely YouTube family. Welcome back to Future Tense. Before we start, I would like you to hit that red subscribe button so that you never miss out on any of our videos. Spanish outfit Bengala declared its interpretation of the Ferrari F12 Berlinetta. As the Spanish plant house declares the preposterous carbon fiber-bodied Ferrari, it's time to investigate the best such from the past. These are probably the most loved mentor-assembled vehicles from ongoing years. During the 30s, with the fast industrialization of the vehicle business and the commoditization of the car, the conventional specialty of coach building wilted. What once was a flourishing industry of many ateliers contracted to simply a modest bunch of organizations working essentially in Britain and Italy. The death of coach-built vehicles was because of the beginning of unibody development and to some extent the Great Depression and the need after World War II to reasonably activate whole countries. In the beginning of automaking, vehicles were a new problematic innovation and individuals needed to depend on old representations to try and sort out them. Recollect what the expression horseless carriage sprung up during the Y2K alarm. At the turn of the earlier century, many individuals considered vehicles ponies and carriages just without the ponies. It was presumably a lot more straightforward to track down a farrier or horseshoe creator than an auto mechanic shop here in Boulder back then. That practice of intricate coach building continued, particularly in Europe, up until World War II. Coach building houses in the UK, Italy, France, Germany, and somewhat else would construct custom bodies for the undercarriage that Bugatti, Alfa Romeo, and other extravagant car makers would deliver. Some ultra-extravagant vehicles were delivered as suspension just, which were then given off to different coach builders. Duesenberg, Bugatti, and Rolls-Royce utilized this technique for creation during the 30s and 40s. However, not to say that coach building is altogether dead, many coach builders collapsed under the new, real factors of assembling, and some started to expand their capabilities, zeroing in on designing or planning. The not very many heritage coach builders still around today made it by developing thusly, working as outside originators for Ferrari or Cadillac or Alfa Romeo. Be that as may, World War II denoted a defining moment in coach building on the grounds that car makers had started to efficiently manufacture their vehicles, picking rather for concurrent monocoque plants in which the body turned into the vehicle's essential help structure. Hand-tailored mentors on top of the creation case basically didn't fit with the post-war producing processes. All things considered, the interest for custom hand-constructed extravagance vehicles that were currently spread around to custom shops, coach builders, and surprisingly, the actual automakers who will take care of custom requests at the right cost. Here we have filtered through some advanced coach-built fabricated exotics for a top 10 countdown. Number 10. Spada Coda Tronca. Worked by Italian outfit Spada Vettura Sport in 2008, this isn't the most lovely supercar we have at any point seen. However, it's great in that you'd be unable to tell there's a C6 aged 7.0-liter Chevy Corvette under that large number of sharp lines. Number 9. Bertone Mantide. Another Corvette, this time a beast of 638-strength supercharged ZR1, and with the renown of Bertone bodywork planned by American Jason Castriota, who already at Pininfarina likewise wrote the Ferrari 599 GTB and the Maserati Gran Turismo. Number 8. Ferrari GG50. To check 50 years of Giorgetto Giugiaro's work, the incredible man planned himself a 612 Scaglietti that we should confront wasn't actually the prettiest Ferrari at any point out of the container. Regardless, Giugiaro's interpretation of the vehicle was his very own method of transport for various years. 7. Ferrari 575 GTZ. This traditional, much prettier than Giugiaro's GG50, understanding of the Ferrari 575M is by the unbelievable Italian plant house Zagato, who was charged by the Japanese authority Yoshiyuki Hayashi to make a vehicle propelled by the 1956 250 GT Zagato. 6. Code 57. Japanese originator Ken Okuyama has Porsche, GM, and Pininfarina work in his sizable portfolio, which additionally incorporates, for some odd reason, a Mitsubishi Colt. This year, he's reported that his Code 57 mentor-assembled supercar will be fabricated restricted to 5 models at $2.5 million each. Clearly, Floyd Mayweather as of now has his own hand. 5. Galpin GTR1. We as a whole know Galpin Autosports from the awful days of MTV's Pimp My Ride and Exhibit. However, the outfit was really genuine when it went to the 2013 Galpin GTR1 dependent on the Ford GT. yet twin-turbocharged to convey north of 1,000 strength. Number 4, Fisker Latigo. At the point when Danish creator Henrik Fisker, BMW Z8, Aston Martin DB9, and so on, established Fisker Coach Build in Irvine, California, his first stop was the 2005 Frankfurt Engine Show for the Fisker Latigo's debut. The vehicle under was really a BMW 6 Series bodied in aluminum and carbon fiber. Number 3, Disco Volante. In 2013, Milan's popular Carrozzeria Touring coach builders paralyzed the world with a cutting-edge variant of Alfa Romeo's 50s Disco Volante. Then at that point, likewise planned by Touring, which means flying saucer, the Disco Volante depended on the Alfa Romeo 8C Competizione. Number 2, Pininfarina P4N5. Director, racer, petrol head, and all-round super-rich fellow James Glickenhaus needed an oddball Ferrari enlivened by the Scuderia's 60s P-Series sports model dashing vehicles. Yet, Ferrari wouldn't give him one. So he burned through $4 million bodying his own Ferrari racer in Jason Castriota's plan and Enzo's V12 motor. Number 1, Pininfarina New Stratos. Devotee's rally driver and financial specialist Michael Stoschek was very enthused about the advanced Lancia Stratos idea spotted at the 2005 Geneva Engine Show and authorized Pininfarina to take a Ferrari F430 and transform it into a 21st century Stratos by hacking 20 centimeters of the wheelbase for a beginning. It doesn't wear the legendary Lancia identification, yet it is one in spirit. That's all for today, folks. I hope you liked the video. If you did, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel so that you never miss any amazing videos from us.